Jaime's family started a ranch in southern Arizona. They raised a lot of cows, and he had what they called a meat plant in Tucson, where they made hamburger and sausage and all kinds of neat stuff and sold it to grocery stores so people could eat it. So he would raise the cows, and they would take them to their meat plant, and they would package all the meat and sell it in stores. And so we've been in Arizona for a long time, and cows have been a big part of their family because of what they've done for a living. Who's ever seen a cow up close? A lot of you guys probably have. Have they been to your place?
We don't have cows. We have horses.
We have horses, okay. Well, we know a lot about horses, too. And so I just wanted to talk to you for a minute about Arizona a little bit and about Matthew's great-grandpa, and we call him Grampy, so everybody can call him Grampy, okay? You want to talk to me?
Just let him go.
Okay. Ready, Grampy? Grampy's going to talk about Arizona and cowboys, because he was a real-life cowboy for a long, long time, still is, and he's going to tell you some stories about growing up in Arizona, and then we'll let Rick talk after that. Why don't you come to the close here?
Well, this hat you never wear it when you was out on the range. It's too big. You have a small hat so it don't get knocked off by the brush. This was only when you went to dance to try to make the girls like it. One would put this old hat on. This here my dad used to wear when he was a cowboy. And I don't know how mine is on. Probably ransacked my closet, and she was right. And then her father also wore them when he was growing up. I'm not going to try and get them on because they're too little. But they should have bought some larger. But the shafts, you know what they're for, going through the cactus and the mesquite. Brush, keep you from getting stuck. And sometimes even if you were walking, and you'd run across the rattlesnake and he'd bite at you and he'd bite your shaft and get your lip. So he would protect you from all that. And it also kept you dry when you're riding. Of course, you have slicker to the way. Now, he spoke about the Indians. When my father first came to Arizona, he was 22 years old. And there were a lot of Indians in southern Arizona at that time. Have any of you heard of Geronimo, the great Indian who lived in southern Arizona, probably stronghold of the Rocky Mountains? My mother's mother had a little store in St. David. And my mother was a young girl, probably about the age of the oldest one here, and one day Geronimo came into the store to buy groceries. And you can imagine how scared she was when she knew that he was an Indian, because they were noted for ransacking the people there in St. David and taking all the things they had. But he was very calm, and he bought the groceries he wanted, and then he went on his way. But at night, when they first moved to St. David, they would all meet in a fort. All the families would meet together in a fort for their protection, because the Indians were mean to the Americans who weren't kind to them. If you treated the Indians real kind, were good to them, didn't give them any problems, they were the best neighbors you could have. There's always some people who wouldn't treat them like they should. And of course that made them mad and they had to suffer the consequence. Now in my day when we went on a roundup, not like they do today, they go in the pickups or the jeeps, or go home at night to sleep in the hotels or in their own homes, we had to go what they called a chuck wagon. It would take your bedding and the food, and of course you would ride your horses. And you would travel through the country gathering the cattle together. And at night, you would stop, and of course you would sleep on the ground in bag, like I'm sure a lot of you children have done. What else do you want me to tell? Story. Good ones or bad ones? Well, one that they always want me to tell, and it was one time I had a little black horse, with one of the best horses I guess that ever was ridden. And he would do just almost anything we wanted him to do. He was very quick, very fast. One time I was up in the Whetstone Mountains. Now, the Whetstone Mountains are up on the west side of St. David, and on the other side is the Trangulums and the other mountains up around Fort Huachuca. And I was up in the tops of these Whetstone Mountains, riding this black horse, and I ran across a big black bear. And I decided that I was going to rope that bear. So I did. I got my lasso and put it on the bear and horse set up. And then the bear, he started coming up toward me, the horse. And when he got real close to me, I jumped off and I ran. And I had to go off a cliff that was about as high as this level, this wall, quite high, real high. And I knew if I jumped off that, this bear wouldn't get me. But when I did jump off, I lived straddle of a big mountain lion. You know what a big mountain lion is? And I looked back, and the bear was jumping too, so kicking that line to make it go fast. And he's running down through all the brush. He wasn't going fast enough, so I just reached down the side here to pick up a stick to whip him, and I picked up a rattlesnake. Then I wasn't still going fast enough, so this side I picked up another stick, and it was a rattlesnake. And we were just going, and bear was after through the brush. After a while, I'll tell you the truth. After a while, we got near my little cabin, and I ran, jumped off, and went, opened the door, and it was locked. But that bear and not lying were both there. So I climbed up one of these big saguaro cactuses. You know what they are? Of course, going through all the brushes, it had torn all my clothes off, and I was new, I was naked. I climbed right up that cactus and stuck on the top. And pretty soon the bear and the mountain lion left, and I just slid down and went into the house. Now that's a false story. That's just a
cowboy story. Cowboy story, yeah.
That's a lie. So you want to be sure when you hear these stories from the cowboys that they're telling you the truth, that they can prove.
Tell them another one of them cowboy stories.
Oh, I put that peach toe right on the end of the arrow. I went up to this canyon. I jumped a big deer, and I pulled up and shot it. And I'm sure that I shot him right in here because it was real close, but he kept running off. Well, 2 years later, I went back up into that same canyon. Peach toe right on the end of the arrow. I went up to this canyon. I jumped a big deer, and I pulled up and shot it. And I'm sure that I shot him right in here because it was real close, but he kept running off. Well, 2 years later, I went back up into that same canyon, and there was a peach tree there. So fruit was ripe, so I climbed up the tree, started eating some of the peaches, and this tree started to move. And I looked down, and that tree seed had grown out of this deer's neck into a big tall peach tree.
That's enough. That's another cowboy story, isn't it?
Now they have electric shavers.